question is in front of you. Can you read the question? I am reading it. The magnesium ribbon, about 2 centimeter long and a piece of coal were taken. X is magnesium ribbon and Y is coal in a glass, and there are 4 students PQRS. Now you have to tell which student has done the right experiment. Flame color is there and residue obtained is there. So flame color for the P student is for with respect corresponding to X is dizzling white flame and grayish ash, and for Y yellowish flame and black ash. Yes, one is A, 2 is B, 3 is C, and 4 is D. Yes, so you can see the options. If you face any difficulty, please let me know. You have last 18 seconds left. Read the options carefully. Okay, time's up. And we are going to see what results. Okay, 40 students have answered right. I want to tell you, magnesium burns with a dazzling white flame, a very beautiful flame, but you can't see when you're without any protective glasses. Dazzling white flame, and when carbon burns, it burns with a sooty flame. So that is the correct answer. B is the correct one. Let's see the leaderboard. Okay, Vaishnav is leading. Don't worry, we have so many questions left. Moving to the next question. Please read question carefully. Which two experiment setup would you choose to prepare and collect hydrogen gas in the laboratory? Please read the question carefully. Please see the options carefully and then answer. Please read the options carefully. How can you prepare the hydrogen gas in the laboratory? The question is simply related to preparation of hydrogen gas. But you need to take care of which metal is used, and second thing is what type of setup should be there. Okay, any problem? One and two are the same. One and two are not same, my dear. One is one and three, and B option is one and four. No options are same. Yes, see carefully. Please read question carefully and last 10 seconds left. Okay, time's up. Fine, let us see how many of you have answered it properly. Oh my God. Let's see how to do this question. If you see, to solve this question, I want to take you to the slide of the question. And question is this. If you want to prepare the HC hydrogen gas, okay, just one second. Yes, can you see my screen? Hydrogen gas you want to prepare, which is the best setup to do that? So answer of this question is D. D is the answer, that is 2 and 3. I want to tell you why 2. First, if you see the difference in 2, 1 and 2 is the nozzle is inside the liquid. You don't put nozzle inside the liquid, because hydrogen, when zinc reacts with HCl, it will give you H2 plus ZnCl2. Okay, it is not a balanced chemical reaction, you can balance it. When you get the hydrogen gas, it will come outside and it will go through this nozzle and it will report here. Once hydrogen gas is taken out, now you need to put the nozzle inside the water, and due to the displacement of air, due to the displacement of water, it is the downward displacement of water. Hydrogen is collected. Here you can collect the hydrogen gas. You don't use oxygen. Can anyone tell me why you don't use oxygen in collecting hydrogen gas?
Oxygen burns.
Very good. Oxygen reacts with hydrogen and there can be explosive reaction. That's why we collect the hydrogen always from the displacement of water. Answer is 2 and 3. Any doubt? Any doubt? Okay, fine. Next question. Okay, I can't put the questions like this because because we are going to see the result also. We have to be continue the process in Mentimeter only. Okay, so next question is in front of you. First, we will going to see the leaderboard. So the results are okay. Aditya NPS RNR is leading the show right now, and he is the fastest. Good, Aditya, keep it up. And the next question is in front of you. Please read the question carefully. These are all NTSC level questions, so read the question carefully. Don't make the mistake. Observe the experiment carefully. China dish is there containing copper powder, and you have a burner. In the above experiment, copper powder turned to black colored product on heating. It is due to the reason that copper has absorbed heat. Copper 2 oxide is formed. It is Roman 2. It's a like oxidation state of copper is 2. They want to say like that. Third option, C option, is copper 1 oxide is formed. That is copper having a 1 oxidation number. Both 1 and 3 are correct. Which is the correct answer among these 4? Don't hurry. You still have time. Take your time and then answer. Which oxide is going to form? Whether oxide will form or not, that is also a doubtful situation. So you have to select answer according to that. Yes, copper powder. Why we do make a powder? To increase the surface area. Those who have doubt why we powder the substances, because to increase the surface area, we powder the substance. Now you have to tell me what will be the possible product. And the answer for this question is we are going to see how many of you have answered it properly. And answer, oh my god, no one has answered A, but only 20 students have answered B. And the answer B is the right one, because copper reacts with oxygen, forms CuO. CuO is plus 2 oxidation state of copper. It does not form Cu2O, it forms CuO. So answer is B. If anyone has any doubt, please let me know. Why not D? Okay, let us see the D option. What is the D option? The D option says that, okay, just a minute. The D option is, so here you have both 1 and 3 are correct. Copper, no, 3 is not at all correct, my dear. Copper is in plus 1 oxidation state in 3. So answer is B only, copper 2 oxide will form. Did you understand? Yes? Very good. No? Aditya, what happened? I told you, both 1 and 3 are not correct. Copper 1 oxide will not form. Copper 2 oxide will form. So how D can be the answer? How is copper 1 oxide formed? Yes, exactly. But is the statement of 1 correct? Copper has absorbed heat. Okay, copper is getting oxidized. Copper is getting oxidized. copper plus oxygen, because what happens when you heat the substance, I want to say that it increases the reactivity of a compound. Actually, it is not absorbing heat, but the later you will learn one thing, that activation energy of the reaction get reduced. It is not like copper has absorbed the heat. The activation energy, it's like climbing up a hill. It's like this. To make the product, if copper and okay, 1 minute. If copper and oxygen are reacting, to make the product as a copper oxide, copper has to go this much height. It's like energy barrier. So that energy barrier is covered by or is given by the heat supply. It is not like copper is absorbing heat. The energy required the heat, because otherwise we call it as a activation barrier. Activation energy or activation barrier. This much energy is required to jump and form the product. Is it clear? Copper reaction is this. Copper plus oxygen to give CuO. Any doubt? Please let me know if anyone has any doubt. No, very good. Moving to the next question. Always remember, activation energy can be taken as a like a climbing a hill. So every reactant needs to have that much energy so that it can go to top of the hill. It is like an example. It must have that much energy to form the product. That's why heat is given. Let us see the leaderboard now. And Aditya, NPS, or NPS, RNR is still leading or not. We will going to see now. Okay, fine. Smrud, NPS, RNR. Very good, Smrud. We are going to do the next question now. Okay, Samrud, whatever. If I have pronounced it wrong, please ignore it. Okay. A dilute solution of sodium carbonate was added to two test tubes, one containing dilute HCl and other containing dilute NaOH. The correct observation was brown colored gas liberated in test tube, brown colored gas liberated in test tube B, a colorless gas liberated in test tube A, a colorless gas liberated in test tube B. Which is the correct answer? Which is the correct answer among these four? Yes, in last class we discussed about sodium carbonate reactions with both of these. I gave you one hint also that time, and we discussed not one question, we discussed so many questions related to this concept. So I am assuming this time you are going to score, all of you are going to write the correct answer only. 30 more seconds left. Okay, so CO2 will come in acid. Are you asking? You are not allowed to ask, Aryan. After the quiz, after 18 seconds, I will answer your question. Sodium carbonate and is added to HCl and NaOH. Okay, last 4 seconds, and question number 4 answer is C. Very good, but still 39 students have answered. Why not all of you have answered this question properly? Fine, we will going to see the leader that thing. So how to solve this question, we are going to check. So see, I told you in the last class that whenever you see Na2CO3, whenever you see Na2CO3, it is nothing but sodium carbonate, and sodium carbonate is a salt of strong base, weak acid. So it is basic in nature because it is formed by NaOH, strong base, and weak acid. When it reacts with HCl, double displacement will happen, NaCl will form, plus H2O plus CO2. If you remember, I told you whenever H2CO3 forms, it will break into this. So colorless gas is obtained. Answer is 3. Any doubt? That is C. If anyone has any doubt, please let me know. Yes, it is unstable. Very good. Now we are moving to the next question. Be ready for that. And next question is in front of you. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Is Samrud still leading the show? 1 minute. Fine, Sneha. Very good, Sneha. Moving to the next question. Please read the question carefully. Question may be big to answer, but read the question. You can see the reactions given. You have to select the correct answer. Please take your time. I have seen two students have already answered, and it's not just 5 seconds. How you have answered, God knows. Carbon plus O2 gives CO2, AgBr gives Ag plus Br2, Zn plus copper sulfate, Ca plus O2, and BaCl2 plus H2SO4. Okay, CO2 plus oxygen. Okay, think properly. Maybe one question have two possibilities. Please read the option carefully. You have to select the best answer. Again, I am repeating, select the best answer. 29 seconds you have, take your time. There are options, that is decomposition also, and there is a double displacement also, there is oxidation also, there is displacement also. Please take your time and then answer. Okay, fine, last 4 seconds. Okay, the answer of question number 5 is B. Very good, students. 42 have answered properly. So, okay, fine. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. The question was very easy. Carbon plus O2 gives CO2. That was the combination reaction. Okay, do you want me to explain? Please let me know. Please write Y if you want me to explain. Please write Y. Please type Y if you want me to explain. Y. Okay, everyone is writing N. Please write Y. No? Fine. It's fine if you have doubt and you didn't understand, I will discuss it. No? Okay, so carbon plus O2 gives CO2 is a combination. BaCl2 reaction was the double displacement reaction. AgBr on heating gives a decomposition, that is Ag plus Br2, like that. And one was the zinc plus some salt of the other acid was other metal was there, that is the displacement reaction. More reactive displaces less reactive from its salt solution. I hope you understood. Please see the leaderboard and check your position. Sneha is still leading or not, we are going to see now. Okay, Sneha is still leading and Vaishnav was the fastest to answer. Vaishnav, be careful in next question. Take your time and then answer. Okay, the question is in front of you. C4H10 plus 13O2 gives you carbon dioxide and water. AgBr gives Ag plus Br2. BaCl2 plus H2SO4 gives this. But there are so many options given. And here it is a multi-correct. These questions are kind of questions asked in NTSC exams. Be careful to answer each and every question. Okay, A, B, C, D is 1, 2, 3, 4 is same like is equivalent to A, B, C, D. Please take your time and answer. Ag, Br is giving Ag plus Br2. Those who have attempted last question properly, this may help. They may get help in this question. Okay, the reaction is, the AgBr reaction is used in a photographic plates. I told you, if you remember, I explained it is used in black and white photography. And BaCl2 reaction is a kind of very important example, and the above one is like hydrocarbon when reacts with oxygen gives you CO2 and water. Okay, we are going to see how many of you have answered it correct. Okay, 24 students, 27 students have answered it wrong. I want to explain you this question, but I will not take much time in explaining. You have to understand it. Okay, fine. See, the question is like C4H10 plus O2, this is oxygen. Okay, it is a combustion reaction. Let me match all the options. So if I try to match this, it is like okay. So this is the answer. This is the combustion reaction as well as it is an exothermic reaction. If you talk about AGBR, AGBR is nothing but a decomposition reaction as well as it is an endothermic reaction. With the help of light, it takes place. That is S and R. Last option, BaCl2 is a precipitation, a white precipitate of barium sulfate. Precipitation means U, and the next is double displacement T. So answer is B. RS, UT, PQ. Hope you understood this. Yes, moving to the next question. Okay, we will see the leaderboard and then we'll move to the next question. Sneha, Vaishnav, Aniket, all are on the first three positions. But now, very good, Harshita. That's a big jump. Okay, fine. Now we are going to go for the next question. Take your time, answer it properly. Question is in front of you. Consider the following statement. Take your time. I'm again repeating, take your time. It is possible to write a simple equation even if we do not know the word equation. Next question. A chemical equation is always written under NTP condition. Okay. For those who don't know NTP, I want to tell you it's a normal temperature and pressure condition. C option, in a chemical equation, the diatomic gases must be written in molecular form. Must be written in a molecular form. Okay, fine. There are four options given to you. You have to select the best answer. 42 students have answered and you have 42 seconds left. So still you need to think. There are options where you have to think and then answer. And this is a part, this is a, this question was taken, is taken from a topic which tells about the chemical equations. So those who were saying, sir, why, again we have a chemical equation, they should know that you should answer all the questions properly. If anyone got 100% marks, this means that you are pro in that chapter. But I don't think that anyone of you have done all the questions right. Maybe you are, there are some students, but we'll see after the result. Okay, time's up. And the answer of this question is D for Delhi. Okay, all reactions are not necessarily to be at the NTP. You may have the many reaction at very high temperature. You may like you okay if you if I tell you like some reaction is taking place at very very high temperature, very very high pressure. Okay, so it doesn't mean that you can't write or that let's say you are writing the Haber's process, N2 plus H2 to form ammonia. It is carried out at very high pressure. So you know how to write the equation. So you can write the equation if the reaction is even not in the atmospheric temperature and pressure condition or normal temperature and pressure. And the second point was that can you write the symbol equation without word equation? You can't write symbol equation without word equation. For symbol equation we need, okay, H2 hydrogen is reacting with oxygen to give water. This means you need to write H2 plus O2 gives water, H2O. And the last option was for the diatomic gas, you always put the molecular form. You never write N plus 3N plus 3H. Can you write like 3N plus 3H gives? Okay, just a minute. Can you write like this? 1N plus 3H gives NH3. Can you write like this? 1N plus 3H gives NH3. No, you can't write N plus 3H. You need to write N2 plus H2 gives NH3. So I hope you understood the concept. ओके इनकॉग्निटो फाइन, हु इज द इनकॉग्निटो. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. टेक योर टाइम टू आंसर द क्वेश्चन. कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट. ऑक्सीडेशन इज द लॉस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम अ सब्सटेंस. रिडक्शन इज गेन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन बाय अ सब्सटेंस. द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ NaCl बाय द एक्शन ऑफ सोडियम एंड क्लोरीन इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रेडॉक्स रिएक्शन. दिस इज रिलेटिवली इजी क्वेश्चन, सो मे बी इट इज इजी और टफ, आई डोंट नो, डिपेंड्स ऑन यू. सो बट डोंट मेक मिस्टेक, टेक योर टाइम एंड देन आंसर. Yes, so you have 50 more seconds left. Let us see how many of you are going to give the correct answer. Okay, Na plus and Cl minus, I want to tell you it's nothing but it's an ionic compound. And how an ionic compound form, you have to think. Fifty-eight students have answered. Still, you have 25 seconds left. Those who have not answered, please answer it quickly. Okay, fine. So, last 5 seconds you have, and the answer is D for Delhi. Oh my God, only still there are many students who have not answered. Okay, fine. So now we are going to discuss. 30 students have given wrong answer and 31 have given the right answer. Question was very easy. I want to tell you that one thing is oxidation is loss of electron, reduction is gain of electron. Two options were right. And how NaCl form, I want to explain you this question. So how NaCl form we will discuss. So I think question was fine. So the question was this, question number 8. Yes. So it says that oxidation is a loss of electron, it's fine. Reduction is a gain of electron, it's fine. I don't think that you have doubt. But when Na and Cl2 reacts, they will give you NaCl. And this is the two times of Na, two times of NaCl. Okay, now if you see the oxidation number change, 0 plus 1. That is a oxidation with the for the Na oxidation. What about Cl2? This is reduction from 0 to minus 1 reduction. It is a kind of redox reaction. D is the answer. Any doubt? Yes. So what we can say, Cl is taking the electron from sodium. One electron is going from sodium to Cl. Understood? It is also a combination reaction, right? Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Okay, if anyone has any doubt, please ask me. Okay, we are moving to the next. First, we'll see the leaderboard. 50% students have done this question wrong, but we will see what is the new scores. And new scores are okay, fine. Who is the incognito? We have to think. We will get to know after the class, I think, or after one question. Okay, so next question is in front of you. Which of the following is an alkali? Please take your time and then answer. Which of the following is an alkali? Okay, don't answer it fast. You may make mistake in this question because options are very good. Options are very good. You have to think which is the correct option. Options are calcium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, and calcium carbonate. Which is the best answer to this question? Okay. What happened, Ananya? Tell me. Question is not displayed. Ananya, question is, which of the following is an alkali? A is calcium hydroxide, B is potassium hydroxide, C is magnesium hydroxide, and D is calcium carbonate. A is calcium hydroxide, B is potassium hydroxide, C is magnesium hydroxide, and D is calcium carbonate. A calcium hydroxide, B potassium hydroxide, C magnesium hydroxide, and D calcium carbonate. Which among the following is an alkali? Okay, fine. And the answer to this question is B. Very good. 37 students have marked it right. Answer is B. Potassium hydroxide is an alkali. The definition of alkali is soluble bases. KOH is a soluble base. Calcium hydroxide is not a soluble in water. Magnesium, okay, we say it's a partial soluble, partially soluble. Calcium hydroxide, partially soluble. Magnesium hydroxide, partially soluble. Calcium carbonate is completely insoluble. So answer is B, KOH. Okay, we are going to see the results now. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. The question is, which of the following gas is evolved on reaction with dilute HCl, dilute hydrochloric acid, with sodium sulfite? Sulfite, P-H-I-T-E, sulfite. Options are carbon dioxide, B hydrogen, C sulfur dioxide, and D sulfur trioxide. Which of the following gas is evolved on reaction with dilute hydrochloric acid with sodium sulfite? Carbon dioxide, hydrogen, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide. Don't guess because options are very good. Take your time and then answer. Sodium sulfite. Sodium sulfite, if you know, there are so many sulfate, sulfite, sulfide. There are so many. Hyposulfite, persulfate, like that. So you need to think, what is the sodium sulfite? Okay, fine. So it's the last 8 seconds left. 4, 3, 2, 1. So the answer of this question is C. Very good. Sodium sulfite is Na2SO3. Na2SO3 is sulfite. Na2SO4 is sulfate. SO4 is sulfate. SO4 2- is sulfate. SO3 2- is sulfite. So Na2SO3 plus HCl gives you double displacement, gives you H2SO3. And in last class I told you, whenever in the product H2CO3 forms, you will break it into H2O and SO2. Any doubt? Please say why. H2SO3 breaks into H2O and SO2. So SO2 is the answer. Any doubt? Please write why. So I will write the reaction, otherwise I will skip. Please write why if you have doubt. No? Fine. Moving to the next question. Plus one for writing reaction. Okay. If you have not written reaction, you would not write the correct answers for this type of question. Okay, I think this time who is leading? Eden. Oh my god. Eden is attempting. Very good, Eden. Next question is in front of you. Take your time and then answer the question. Please read the options carefully. Okay.
Sir, could you read the question? It's not visible for me.
Okay. Leave this question. Just leave this question. It's not visible. Leave it for everyone. It's not visible. Okay, fine. So leave this question. Leave this question. Don't answer. If you answer, you may lose the marks. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Okay, so moving to the next question, please read the question carefully. Which one observation is correct according to effects of acid and bases on some indicators? Please take your time and answer the question. Which one observation is correct according to effects of acid bases on some indicators? Dilute HCl is used, dilute H2SO4 is used, calcium hydroxide is used, and magnesium hydroxide is used. You have to tell the effects on the various indicators. What is the effects on indicators? So, calcium, take your time and answer this question. With the help of this question, I want to tell you one important thing. So, after finishing this, I will tell you that. Okay, fine. So, the answer for this question is okay, fine. So, answer for this is okay, 36 of you have answered it right. Very good. Now, I want to tell you very important thing related to this question. Why I have added this question? So that I can tell you one important part with the help of this question. So, question was, what is the effect of an indicators? So dilute HCl on red litmus and all, you know that. So I want to tell you one thing. This question is related to red litmus, blue litmus, phenolphthalein and methyl orange. But if I give you one new indicator, can you tell me what will be the answer? If you have a red cabbage, if you have a red cabbage, what will be the color change? Can you please write? In the neutral, you have three options: neutral, acidic, and basic. Please write the color of red cabbage. I want to see how many of you know this. Color of red cabbage in acid, neutral, and basic medium. Okay, acid is red. Okay, fine. What about other? I gave you this as an assignment. Okay, purple, purple, green. Fine. Okay, fine. Neutral is purple. I want to tell you the answer for this question. I think most of you have answered. With red cabbage, can't identify acid and neutral solution. Here you will have the color as a red only. It can't identify because it's acidic in nature. Base will give you the green color. So this is a very important part. One more question I want to ask. What is the methyl orange? It is given in this. Methyl orange, always remember. Methyl orange always give you, there are again three, NAB. What is the answer for NAB, methyl orange? NAB? Methyl orange, NAB? Okay, wrong. Anyone else? Methyl orange? No, wrong. It's a neutral, acidic and basic. It's wrong. Okay, fine. One student has given right. Anyone else? Okay, red, Shraduli. Anyone else? Okay, write in the same order because there are so many messages coming up, so I can't read all the messages. Okay, three students have given right. ORY. Very good, Shraduli. Okay, those who have given the right answer, I'm telling you what is the correct answer for this. On methyl orange, it is For neutral, it is orange only because the name is methyl orange. And for acid, it is red. And for base, it is yellow. For base, it is yellow. So I remember it like Moby. Methyl orange base. Oh, sorry, not Y. Methyl orange base yellow. Otherwise, acid is red. Here also acid red. Red cabbage. One last question. Phenolphthalein. What is the color of phenolphthalein in basic medium? Very, very important. It turns pink. And when it is an acidic medium, no effect on phenolphthalein. Very, very important point. Okay. And the litmus is, you know, all the litmus color. The last question I want to ask you, like, what is the universal indicator color change? Universal indicator. If you have a universal indicator and you have, let's say pH is 7. pH is 7 means a neutral solution. Can you tell me what is the color of a universal indicator at pH 7? I can bet that most of you will give the wrong answer. Colorless, wrong. Purple, wrong. Blue, wrong. Blue, wrong. Very good. Many of you have given right answers. So answer is green color is the neutral solution. pH is neutral, it is green. It is a very different. Okay, if I want to ask one more thing. If one is blue and one is purple, one is blue and one is purple, which you are going to say that which is more acid, which is more basic? Which is more basic when one is blue and one is purple? Any idea? Purple is more basic. Very good. That is the important part. This is more basic and this is less basic. Okay. And you know that red represent the acidic strength. Okay, fine. So this is all about the methyl orange. Moving to our next question. Get ready for that. Okay. So next question, first we'll see the leaderboard, and leaderboard says that okay, so Aniket is leading. Just moving to the next question, I skipped one point. Just tell me what will be the pH of the, whether it's acidic or basic, if universal indicator gives you yellow color. If universal indicator gives you yellow color, what is the solution? Is it acidic or basic? Universal indicator. Very good. It is acidic. And if it is a orange? If it is a orange, then? Orange, then acidic. Now, last question. Orange and yellow, which represent more basic solution? Among orange and yellow, which represent more basic? Which represent more basic? Okay, oh my god, many of you are wrong. Which represent more basic solution among orange and yellow? The answer is yellow, not orange. I want to tell you the colors. First is the red, then orange, then yellow, then green, then blue, then purple. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Please remember it. It's a very, very important. Okay, fine. Yes, yellow is more, orange is more acidic. Very good. Next question is in front of you. Okay, if we have the two test tubes A and B containing HCl and CH3COOH. On mixing both acids, which are having pH equals to 2 and pH equals to 6, pH of the resultant solution will be what? You can see in the diagrams given, you have to tell the pH of the resultant solution. pH of the resultant solution will be more than the values given to you, like more than 6 or less than 2, more than between 2 and 6, and pH will be 7. maybe it gets neutralized, so it will give you the 7 pH. Okay, 57 have answered. Still, you have 22 seconds left. I think you can read the question properly. 58. Now you have to answer it fast, students. Only 10 seconds left. Those who have not answered, please answer it. Okay, fine. The answer of this question is C. More than, okay, 23. 29 students have answered it wrong. So one thing I want to tell all of you, see, if you have these type of questions, if you have these type of questions, the solution is very easy. Yes, yes, I will tell you. Wait. Please give me 1 second. Okay, fine. So see, how to solve these type of questions. Whenever pH is given to you, okay, pH is 2. pH represents the H plus strength. pH 2 and pH 6. So what I will write? Less the pH, more the acidic. More acidic means more H plus concentration. More H plus in the solution. pH 6, less acidic. Less H plus. Okay, now try to understand, if you mix the solution, it is having a more H plus. Okay, let's take the value. So if it is having a more H plus and it is having a less H plus, you know, the volume got doubled. So try to understand like this. Let's say it is having the 5H plus. I'm just giving you a random example because you don't know how to calculate pH. That's why I'm giving you this example. You have a 5H plus and let's say this is having a 2H plus and volume is 1 liter and volume is 1 liter. When you mix it, you got 2 liter volume, but H plus are 7 now. Now, if you calculate the ratio, actually the concentration of H plus is nothing but number of H plus that we call as a moles divided by volume. So if you see, 5 by 1 is in the first case. If I call it as a case A, 5 by 1. In case of A, 5 by 1 concentration. In case of B, 2 by 1 concentration. But in case of C, 7 by 2 is the concentration. This is the case C, where you have already mixed. So now calculate which is the higher. This is all like a pH. So it is the highest concentration, lowest pH. That is 2. 2 by 1 is definitely, it is like a pH 6. So pH 6 is there. Now 2 by 1, 7 by 2 comes between 5 by 1 and 2 by 1. 7 by 2 is nothing but 3.5. So 3.5 is come between 5 and 2. That's why answer is 3. If anyone has any doubt, please let me know. It is totally based on concentration of H plus. Concentration of H plus. Okay, can I say that concentration of H plus will reduce as compared to test tube A. Any doubt? Please let me know if anyone has any doubt. No? And it is also representing CH3COH is very, very weak acid. So the acid gives the reaction like this. It is actually a reversible reaction. H plus plus CH3COO minus. Reversible means all CH3COH is not breaking into H plus and CH3COO minus. Am I clear? So that's why pH is very, very high. But in case of HCl, whole HCl will break down. H plus plus Cl minus. There is no reversible sign. But here you have a reversible sign. Okay. So next question is, so first we'll see the leaderboard. So who is leading this time? Aniket Gupta, INR 10. Very good, Aniket. Moving to the next question. Okay, I will answer this question after finishing this. How it is reversible in case of weaker acid? Momita De, I will tell you after this question. Do this question, then I'll explain. How do we separate this mixture? Okay, wait, I'll answer this question. First, you do this. KNO3 is given to you, AgNO3 is given to you, MgCl2 is given to you, NH4 whole twice, CO3 is given to you, and NaCl is given to you. What is the match of A, B, C, D, and E? What is the correct match for A, B, C, and D, and E? You have 47 seconds left. And answer for this question is, take your time, write the reactions, how these salts are formed. If you remember how the salts are formed, you may get the answer. Okay, I think very less have answered. This means that you people are thinking and you are going to write the correct answer. Yes. Okay. So time's up, and the answer for this question is okay. 26 has answered wrong. 28 have answered right. Rest have not answered at all. Okay, fine. Why you people have done this? This question is not that tough. So question is like, you have the different salts, and if you remember, salts are formed by crisscross method. Okay, so KNO3. If you remember, K is positive, K plus, and NO3 minus. By the crisscross of KNO3, okay, I'll write like this: K plus, NO3 minus. Okay, now KOH, it must have formed from KOH because, and it must have formed from HNO3. When you make it react, double displacement, neutralization reaction, KNO3 with H2O will form. Similarly, Ag plus I will write, plus NO3 minus I will write. Same thing, what you are going to write for silver. Okay, now here you have a nitrate, and other than that, it's a silver hydroxide. AgOH whole twice plus HNO3 will give you this product. Similarly, Mg2 plus and Cl minus crisscross give this. So with plus just add hydroxide, with minus add H plus. So you will get HCl. HCl is one of the reactant, and MgOH whole twice is another reactant. Similarly, NaCl, similarly NH4CO3. NH4CO3 is nothing but NH4 whole twice, CO3 is nothing but, it is our crisscross method. But if you remember, NH4 is one of the ion, CO3 2 minus is one of the ion. By crisscross method, you will get NH4 whole twice this. But you want to tell the acid and base, with plus you will get the hydroxide, that is NH4OH, and with carbonate you will put H plus, so that is H2CO3. Understood? Okay, those who have searched the elements, I'm telling you, it's not the good way. If you are, okay, tell me, for answering this, you have searched the elements and you got the answer, that's a different point. Did you understand the method, how to tell the product? If I give you a very random example, a very different example, let's say zinc phosphate, Zn3PO4 whole twice. Can you tell me what is the acid and what is base? Now tell me, then I will get to know whether you are right or wrong. Zn3PO4 whole twice, which is acid and which is base, which form this salt? Can you answer? Write full thing. Which is acid and which is base? Now see, many, very, many few of you have answered. Okay, it's wrong, Aryan. Anyone else? No one has given the proper answer. Very good, Momita Day. Wrong, Purav. Sneha, write the full answer. Surya, wrong. Aslesha, right. Laksh, right. Okay, again, same thing. Zn plus 2, PO4, 3 minus. With plus 2, you will put OH minus. Zn OH whole twice. With PO4, 3 minus, put H plus. H3PO4. This is the way to tell which are the acid and which are the base which formed the product. Okay, now one student has asked, like, sir, why weak acid does not dissociate completely? You know what happens? Because there is a, in weak acid, you may not get reversible reaction because these are not having tendency to lose H plus. So this reaction tries to go in backward direction. This reaction tries to go in backward direction because it does not lose H plus easily. Okay, so that's why these reactions are reversible reactions. Understood, Momita? But in case of HCl, it will break into H plus and Cl minus. Understood? Okay, fine. Now, someone has asked how to separate. See, these are the soluble things. All this, if you mix these two things, you will get H plus, you will get Cl minus, you will get CH3COO minus, you will get, that's it, CH3COOH. Now, you can't separate like Cl minus and CH3COO minus. You can do one thing, just put some ion which can form precipitate with Cl minus. Can you answer this? How to separate Cl minus and CH3COO minus? Who can answer this if these two are mixed in one salt? If these two are mixed, how can you separate? Anyone? How can you separate if you have in a test tube these two ions? How can you separate? No one? Not electrolysis. Anyone else? You have these two ions, acetate and Cl minus. How can you separate? Okay, you add Ag. When you add Ag, AgCl will precipitate and CH3CO minus will remain as it is. Did you understand? Someone has asked very, very good question. Who was that? I forget his name. That how to separate these two? Just add Ag. So what you are going to get, AgCl will get deposit on the bottom and CH3CO minus remain in the solution. Understood? Okay, what about Na? Na remain as it is. NaCl is soluble. It will not precipitate. AgCl is precipitate. Na plus remain in the solution. Don't worry. Understood? Okay, when you add Na, both are soluble. Your purpose will not get solved. NaCl is soluble. CH3COONa is soluble. You will not get precipitate. You have to add something which will form precipitate with one and soluble with other. Understood? Very good question. Okay, fine. To separate two things, always remember you add something which is soluble in one and insoluble in other. Let's see the leaderboard and see the end today's result. And today's result says that the one who win this quiz is incognito. Okay, why not soluble both and then crystallize? My dear, when you crystallize, you can do this thing, but you know what will happen? You can do this thing also, but there must be very huge difference in the temperature of the crystallization when crystallization happens. Understood? Because there are chances that when you crystallize, the other salt will also get crystallized. So it is a very carefully you have to do that. So we don't go for the expensive techniques when you have some easy techniques to carry out. Understood? Easy technique is what? Just add the more, just add something which will form precipitate. Understood? Okay, fine. Thank you, all of you. Hope you understood something, some new things today. Thank you.